Yes, hi guys. Now, the next topic of irrational functions should be integration of irrational functions. This is integration of irrational algebraic functions we are discussing about. Okay, so irrational algebraic functions we are discussing about. Algebraic functions. So, next process in the lecture 29, let me discuss about a specific kind of irrational functions. Okay, in this case we will take in the denominator. The denominator is having quadratic function without radical sign, without square root or cube root or something, and other is quadratic equation again which is under the radical sign. This kind of situation, if arises, what kind of integration is to be done? I mean, to make it integrable function, we have to just convert it to integrable function. For that one, we have to substitute. Here we are making the irrational function first into a rational function, then we will integrate it. So making it integral function, first of all we have to make irrational function into a rational function, which we are doing for the last 25th lecture, 26th, 27th, 28th, 29th. So I just ended in 32 lectures. Okay, so series of lectures which is going to end maybe up to 30. So 32 lectures I have taken from 25th onwards, 25th, 26th, 27th, 28th, 29th, 30th, 31st, 32, means 8 lectures are there. 8 series of lectures I have taken from irrational functions, irrational algebraic functions, integration of irrational algebraic functions. Okay, that I am continuing here. Now this is one of the special kinds. Now these questions, as I always say, taken from the students' queries, okay, or online students, and in the class studies we have taken this, I mean, the new students from, okay, other kind of students, means CA intermediate courses, when they enter for the CA courses, then they enter for intermediate courses, so then they are also integration differentiation there, so we have just discussed that, okay, and number of other classes, we have applied mathematics there. Is used. Okay, so for those students, okay, their queries are taken. So all these questions are from their queries. Okay, so this is something clarification about my questions from where I have taken them. Now question is the special kind of integration. Now integration, all these questions are based upon the special kind of integration. What is the type of this integration? So specific kind of integration. Specific type of integration of an irrational algebraic function. Let me take this character. Irrational algebraic function. Which is of this type, integration of a special type. Let me take 1 upon, in the denominator we have one function which is, let me take ax square plus b under the square root, let me take cx square plus d, okay, ds. This is another kind of special function, which we can take here constants. Any other constant, let me take px square plus q, and this is rx square plus s. Okay, that can also be taken. Constants are a, b, c, and d. Now, this kind of question is that under the radical sign we have quadratic function, and out of the radical sign also we have quadratic function. Up to now, we have discussed about linear functions which are out of this radical sign. Okay, so up to 28th question. We were taking here linear function in the 28th lecture, but here was quadratic function, but now quadratic function outside it. Okay, this is one of the specific kind of integration, which are questions based upon this type. Now how to integrate this kind of question? What we have to consider, what we have to substitute? There is double substitution here. The reason I'll talk about later, but first let me tell you that what is the process of integrating this kind of function. First of all, what we do, the first step is, let me write it, step number one. step one. Substitute or substituting, substitute x is equal to, here this x is equal to 1 upon t that we get. Okay, then what is the differentiation? I mean, then differentiate it, that substitute x equal to 1 upon t and differentiating it, then sorry, differentiating it with respect to t. Differentiating it with respect to t. With respect to t. Okay. So we get here present dx dt is equal to minus 1 upon t square. Imply that dx equal to minus dt upon t square. Okay, so this is the first step. What we do? We substitute x equal to 1 t. Now after substitution, second step is substitute these values here. What we obtain? We obtain in the denominator, therefore, sine of integration 1 upon ax square plus b under the square root cx square plus d dx now is converted into, is transposed into minus sine dt upon t square sine of integration divided by, now this is a into x square, that means a upon t square, a upon t square, because x is 1 upon t, x is 1 upon t, so x square is 1 upon t square, plus b, okay, under the square root also, this is c upon x square, or c upon t square, this is c upon, now we have transposed this into t, c upon t square plus t, okay, and this dt already are written down. So what we get here, this is minus sine dt, okay, upon t square divided by, here t square will be the LCM, it will be a plus b into t square, okay, and here, and the t square, this t square will come in the numerator, or you may say this, like, let me take t square, this t square and this t square cancel out, and under the square root, this will be c plus d into t square under the square root upon t, because out of the square root LCM was t inside the radical sign, t square was LCM, but out of radical sign it will be t only, t will come in the numerator, which will be minus sine t dt divided by a plus b t square under the square root c plus dt square. Okay, now this is, now in the numerator we have t dt. Now how to remove it, t dt? If we assume something, that t dt equal to something, okay, will be what u dt, suppose. With this we have to assume second step. Now this is the second step written. The second was, this is step number 2. Let me substitute second step, let me write here. This was the second step, step 2 was, substitute that value in the second was. Now third step, what we do? Further substituting step number third. This is step 3. What we do? Further substitute or substituting this under the square root value, complete value, that c plus dt square is equal to u square. Alright. So what do we get here? This whole value will be u square, differentiating with respect to u, differentiating it with respect to u, we get, this will be 0 c, but d into 2 d t, okay, dt upon du, equal to twice u, or d into t into dt, 2 to cancel out, will be u du, okay, and take this d, this is d to that side, it will be upon d, d dt equal to u upon d d, or u du upon d, that will be the value here, we substitute, this is u, and this is that value. What is the final answer here? I think right. Sorry, here. So then the fourth step, now substitute the values. Substituting the fourth step is step number fourth. Step four. Now substituting these values here in this equation. Which one? This one. This is, let me take second equation. But the first one is the second equation. And now substituting these values. Substitute. Okay. Substituting the values in second, in the second equation, what we get? U d u upon a is equal to that. Give me negative sign. Look right here. Minus sign. This is u d u upon b divided by. Now here it will be, okay, this, therefore t dt equal to, this whole value will be converted, what is t, t square then, t square equal to u square minus c upon d, it will be u square minus c, let me write here, but from this what do we get, t square is equal to u square minus c upon d. This value is in place of d, t square. T square is this value. So this value will be substituted. Okay, so let me write. We have to call this second step. So finally, what do we get? The third equation. It will be a plus b into t square. T square is u square minus c upon d. Value of t square here. Okay, out of this bracket. And under the square root, it is u only, but this is out of this u. This u and this u cancel out. D will come here. This will be, let me write, this is minus sign du upon this d and this d. This is in the LCM. And we cancel out. It will be ad, numerical value. Okay, plus b u square minus b c upon d, let me write here, upon d, d d cancel out. Finally, we get what kind of, this is just out of this value. Okay, so this we have obtained here, what value, this is minus sign d u upon, let me write a d minus b c, or first let me write, this is b u square minus, sorry, plus a d minus b c. Okay, take b common. So we will take then b common from this, it will be minus sign 1 upon b capital, this is d u upon u square plus whatever this value comes out. This is a d minus b c upon b. Let me take this something, a constant value whole square. This is suppose u, let me take, or any number I can take this. Okay. Let me take this is equal to minus 1 upon b du sign of integration upon u square plus, let me take alpha square. Okay. Where alpha is equal to ad minus bc upon b in this case. Okay, so this is what? Minus 1 upon b into 1 upon alpha, okay, tan inverse u upon alpha. Tan inverse y, u is x square plus constant square. Okay, so this is u upon alpha. Now alpha can be substituted, u can be substituted. U was here, this value cx square plus d was considered as, sorry, that was, I'm sorry, c plus dt square was u. So if I substitute here, so finally substituting that value, we will take the fourth step. The final answer is this. This is minus 1 point b into alpha tan inverse u is c plus gt squared on alpha, alpha is this whole value under the square root of this, okay, under the square root of this, because alpha is under the square root, and then whole square, alpha square is this whole value, this is alpha square equal to this, or alpha equal to under root of this, alpha is equal to under root of this, AB minus BC upon B, okay, in this case, this is alpha, alpha equal to under root of that value. This is whole value plus constant C, we can write it is answer in this case. This way, in this way we will, okay, solve all these questions. This is the process of the four steps here, which are clarified, that if there is a quadratic equation out of the radical sign and under the radical sign also quadratic equation, then how to integrate, how to convert this into integral function, this is irrational function. How to convert this irrational function into integral function, then integrate. This is the process of integration of this kind of question. And let me take the questions now. All these questions are based upon this one specific type of irrational function. Okay, let me take now this type of functions. Question number now 1, 2, and how many? 12 questions are there. Okay, all these 12 questions are based upon this one basic type of question type. Now let me take question number 1. Let me solve it. This is kind of integration 1 upon 1 plus x square under the square root to do 1 minus x square dx. So let us take x equal to for substitution. So first step is substituting or putting substituting x equal to 1 upon t. Therefore, dx equal to minus dt upon t square. This always we do. Differentiating it with respect to t. Dx upon dt will be minus 1 upon t square. Take dt to that side, it will be minus dt upon t square here. But during the 28th lecture also. Okay. Same process, substituting this here. What we get, this is minus dt upon t square in the numerator. Okay. Divided by, this is 1 plus 1 upon t square. Under the square root, 1 minus 1 upon t square. Okay, so finally we get here minus sign dt upon t square. In the denominator we will get t square plus 1 under the square root. This is t square minus 1 divided by t cube. T square from this and t from this out of square root. This will be t. T cube there. This t will come in the denominator or in the numerator. It's t cube. So t square will be cancelled out. Finally, we will get minus sin t dt divided by 1 plus t square under the square root t square minus 1. Okay, so now substituting t square minus 1 equal to u. Further substituting, let me write here. This is equation number, let me take second. This is first one. So, substituting, further substituting. Further substituting or putting, further substituting t square minus 1 equal to u square. We always remove this radical sign because we have to convert this still into irrational function. To convert this irrational function into rational function, for that radical sign is to be removed. For that, we have to consider this t square minus 1 equal to u square. Differentiating it with respect to u. Differentiating it with respect to u. With respect to u. Okay, so we get, what do we get here? This is 2t into dt is equal to 2u into du. Directly that will be t dt equal to u du. Here we will substitute. Therefore, this finally will be converted as u du divided by, this is 1 plus. What is t square? T square is equal to, this t square equal to u square plus 1. By substituting here, u square plus 1 in place of t square. 1 plus t square. T square is u square plus 1. U square plus 1. T square equal to. Okay, so this is out of the square root value. And this is u. U square, which we have already consider d square minus 1 equal to u square, under the square root u square, u square and sorry, square and this square root will be cancelled out. Finally, we get minus sign u d upon u square plus 2 into u, this u cancel out. Finally, we get minus sign du upon u square plus under root u whole square. We can write that this is nothing but minus sign 1 upon root 10 inverse u upon root. Just write once. It will be minus 1 upon root 10 inverse. 10 inverse. Okay. U. Now u is this under root of t square minus 1 upon under root of 2. T square, both are under the square root. So we can take 2 also under the square root. Let me take plus constant. Now t is to be substituted as 1 upon x. Okay, t is equal to 1 upon x. Substituting t is equal to 1 upon x. Finally, we get minus 1 upon root. This is 10 inverse. Okay, it will be 1 minus x square under the square root. Under the square root. 1 minus x square upon this 1 upon x square. It will be x square out of this under root 2. Sorry, 2x square. This value will be there. Okay, so only we have to substitute t equal to 1 upon x, that means 1 upon x square, or 1 minus x square upon x square, under root 2 x square, it will be, or x under root 2. Okay, plus constant c, if I write it again, it will be minus 1 upon root 2, 10 inverse, under root 1 minus x square, upon x root 2. Okay, this is the value of this, plus constant c. Finally, this is the answer. But finally, we have to find out the answer in x, in terms of x. In terms of x, we have to convert t into x, finally tell in x terms. This is the answer here. Question number 1 is solved. Okay, so this is question number 1 first. First question we have done. Let us talk about the next question. Second one. The process I am talking about and the questions are clarifying. It is just for illustration all these questions are taken for that. One can understand that how to proceed for solving this kind of questions. Okay, let me take next question. So, what is the next question? Second question. Now, question number second. Okay. The sign of integration, this is 1 upon x square under root. This is 1 plus x square dx. Again, substituting. So putting x equal to 1 upon t, therefore dx differentiating it with respect to t will be dx upon dt equal to minus 1 upon t square into dt for t square. Okay, so substituting this value here, finally we get this is minus dt upon t square divided by 1 upon t square is under the square root. 1 plus 1 upon t square, it will be again t cube. This t square cancel out. And this t will come in the numerator. This is minus sign t dt upon under root 1 plus t square. Okay, t square plus 1 or 1 plus t square doesn't matter. Okay, again, now this is under the square root, substituting 1 plus t square equal to u square. Again putting 1 plus t square equal to u square, or differentiating it with respect to u, it will be 2t into dt equal to 2u into du. Okay, we always do like this. This is cancelled out. Why? Or we can say that 2t dt upon du equal to take du to the side, cancel out, d dt equal to u du. Okay, so let me substitute here. So nothing but minus sign, this is u du upon u only. This under the square root, will be u square and u square will cancel out of this, u will cancel out of this. Only minus u plus constant c, let me tell you. Now u is under the square root minus sign 1 plus t square from this plus constant c. Now what is the value of this t? Now t is 1 upon x. It will be 1 plus or 1 plus x square upon x out of this one plus constant c. Okay, so because square, x square will come out of them, because it's a square by the LCM, 1 upon x square, it will be x square plus 1 upon x square, but the square root from x square is cancelled out, only x. This is the final answer. This is the final answer. Question number second, we have done. Okay, so question number second. Now let us talk about next question. Now, question number third, let us talk about. Now, question number third. So, we are doing quadratic functions in the denominator with a radical sign as well as without radical sign if they are in multiplication. How to integrate them via the irrational functions, irrational algebraic functions. Okay, which are to be converted into rational functions first, then integrate. So, integrable functions which are rational, then we can integrate them. So, convert them into rational functions first. That is, now next question is sign of integration 1 upon, it's also a square root, it is x square under the square root x square minus dx. Second and third of similar type, x square it is having independent. So putting again, so first of all, we put or putting x equal to 1.2. Therefore, differentiating it with respect to t, we get dx upon dt equal to minus 1 upon t square, or dx equal to minus dt upon t square. This is substituting this value, we get minus sign t dt upon t square upon 1 upon t square under the square root 1 minus t square upon t. But under the square root, only square root is in the numerator. Denominator is cancelled out. So it's only t cube, so it will be t square cancelled out. So the same value, minus sign is t dt, but under the square root, 1 minus t square. Okay. So again substituting, or again putting 1 minus t square equal to u square, differentiating it with respect to u, we get it will be minus 2t into dt equal to 2u into du, 2 cancel out, so t dt equal to, okay, this is the minus sign will be cancel out, then it will be u d positive upon u only. Cancelled out. Answer is u plus constant c of integration. Constant of integration. So u only. What is u? Under root 1 minus t square plus constant c. So u is under root 1 minus t square. But t is what? 1 upon x. It will be x square minus 1 upon x plus constant c. 1 minus. This is the answer here. So this is the answer of question number third. Alright, this is question number third. Okay, now let us talk about question number fourth. What is question number fourth? Let's do. Okay, so question number fourth now. Question number fourth, what does it say? It's sign of integration 1 upon it is x square plus 1 under the square root this x square minus dx. Again putting x equal to 1 upon t, differentiating it with respect to t, we get with respect to t. with respect to the t here, with t, we get dv dx upon dt minus 1 upon t square, or dx equal to minus dt upon t square. Substituting these values here, this is given equation. What it is? It will be sum of integration minus dt upon t square. And this is 1 upon t square plus 1 under this one, 1 upon t square minus 1. Again, the same thing. It will be minus t dt divided by 1 plus t square under the square root of 1 minus t square. Because if we take t square as same, 1 minus t square upon t, t will come in the numerator, this t dt. But this t square, which is as same, cancel out with this. It will be 1 plus t square only. So again, substituting 1 minus t square equal to u square, or minus 2t into dt equal to 2u into du, cancel out, minus t dt equal to u du. This is negative sign, here also negative sign, so minus t dt equal to directly u du positive, divided by, this is 1 plus, now u square, or t square equal to u square plus 1, u square plus 1. Under the square root, it is u square, so it is u, only u cancelled out. Sign of integration, this is du upon u square plus 1. Okay, can be written as sign of integration du upon u square plus under root 2 whole square, under root 2 whole square, x square plus a square type. Answer will be 1 upon root 2, tan inverse u upon root 2. Okay, this is plus constant of integration. Substituting the value of u, 1 upon root 2, tan inverse. Now u is under root 1 minus t square. Okay, upon root 2. Putting value of t also, 1 upon root 2, tan inverse. Under the square root, this is 1 upon x. T is equal to 1 upon x. It will be x square minus 1 upon root 2 into x, because x will come out, or x square will be there, so it will be x.